Good morning. Thank you for joining us for this week's edition of Major Mondays. I'm Adam Beals. I'm the Director of International Student Advising at Green River College. And today I'm going to be talking to you about our Bachelor's of Applied Science degrees. And these are our four-year degrees, and there's two entry points into the degree. Students can either enter at year one and complete a two-year associate degree at Green River and then continue on for years three and four at Green River to complete the bachelor's degree, or students have the option of transferring to Green River having completed an associate degree elsewhere. And for many of these degrees, it's not necessary to have completed an associate degree in the specific field that you're planning to do your bachelor's degree in. If you're transferring to Green River, for example, with an associate in arts degree from another college, you can take a few prerequisite courses and still gain admission into, for example, our IT software development program. And that IT software development program is the first program that I'm going to talk about today. This is our most popular program at Green River, and the reason for its popularity is the tremendous success that our graduates have had in terms of getting employment after completing their studies. Green River College is located near to Seattle, and this is a huge hub for tech and for software companies. Companies like Microsoft, Amazon, Expedia, all have their global headquarters in Seattle, and they're always looking to hire new tech talent. So our graduates have gone on to work for Amazon. We also have a recent graduate who's working for Disney as a software engineer, and the starting salaries for these positions on average is about $100,000. So high chance of getting employed and high compensation once these students find a job. This program requires that you either complete a software development associate degree at Green River, or you can transfer in from another college, as I mentioned before. If you're transferring to Green River and you have an associate degree that's not in software development, then you would need to take some prerequisite courses. There's 3/4 worth of prerequisite courses, so that's about 9 months of study, and the timing tends to work out pretty well with this, because applications for the program open in January and the program starts in September and December. So for example, students hoping to start in the fall of 2021, they would need to apply in January of 2021. And that gives them that 9-month window to complete those prerequisite courses if they don't have them already. Students who do the IT associate degree at Green River, the prerequisite courses are baked into that degree, so they can transition smoothly directly into our software development bachelor's program. With those prerequisite courses and with the associate degree, you need to have an average GPA of 2.5, which is about 80%, and you'd also need to have a 2.5 in an intermediate Java programming class. This program features two capstone courses. These are done typically in the last 2/4 of enrollment in the program, and these are a great opportunity to get an internship. So students often find companies that will hire them on to do about 6 months of oftentimes paid work. And while doing that work, students are also getting credits towards their degree. So that way, when they graduate, the students have the experience they need to land a really exciting job in this field. We also have another IT computer science related program. This is our information technology bachelor's program in cybersecurity and networking. And as we have gone more and more online due to COVID, more and more companies are hiring people up for cybersecurity to make sure their information stays protected. So again, great job opportunities in this field. Starting salaries for a network administrator is about $75,000. For a security analyst, it's $85,000 starting salary right after you finish your bachelor's degree. The entry requirements for the cybersecurity program are an associate degree. Again, it does not have to be in IT. However, if you do not complete the IT associate degree at Green River, then you're looking at 8 courses that you would want to complete prior to starting the bachelor's program. So again, you can complete all prerequisite courses in 3/4, 9 months, or alternately, you can just start at Green River, do our IT associate degree, and then transition directly into the bachelor's in cybersecurity and networking. So those are our two kind of computer science IT related fields. We also have two very popular bachelor's degrees related to business. The first one is marketing and entrepreneurship. And similar to our computer science programs, this program starts in the fall or winter. One difference with this program is it's a little shorter to complete. So this program is only 18 months. So students who start in their associate degree with us, that takes 2 years. They have an additional 18 months for their bachelor's. So they're getting their bachelor's degree in 3.5 years as compared to 4 years, which is more common for most bachelor's degrees. So this is a little bit of an accelerated program. It's a cohort-based program. So you'll work closely with the same students throughout the program. It features a lot of group work and a lot of project-based learning. So this is a great program for people who want to go into marketing. Also a really good program for people who have kind of an entrepreneurial spirit and want to start their own startup. One of the projects that you do in this class is that you do product development and you create a prototype of a product that you want to sell at your company. And then you actually pitch this product to a panel of industry experts and leaders from the Seattle area who will then give you feedback on both the product and your pitch. So it's a lot like that TV show Shark Tank and gives you a lot of real world experience in terms of developing a product. The other business program that we have is Applied Management. And this is more of a traditional business program. It gives you an overview of operational management for all areas of a business. This program leads students into management positions where the salary on average is $60,000 to $100,000 in the King County area for students who have a bachelor's degree. The requirements for this program are similar to the marketing and entrepreneurship program. Marketing and entrepreneurship requires an associate degree with a 2.5 GPA, including a 2.5 grade in college level math and English classes. For the marketing and entrepreneurship, there are also two business classes that you need to take before joining that program if you didn't complete an associate in business degree. For the applied management bachelor's program, there aren't any prerequisites. So you can go directly into that program regardless of what your associate degree was, so long as you have previously completed some associate degree. The next program that I'll talk about is our natural resources program. And this is a very exciting program that really leverages some of the unique qualities of Green River. Specifically the fact that at Green River College, we have a 200 acre forest located right on campus with hiking trails that run through it. And the Green River also runs through it. And there's a twice annual salmon run up the Green River. So this, as you can imagine, provides all kinds of opportunities for hands-on learning for our students who maintain the forest there. They maintain the hiking trails, and they also do water quality testing on the river. So if you enjoy being outside, if you love being in nature, if you enjoy working with your hands, this is a great program for you. I often get questions from students about what are some of the jobs that I could do potentially with a bachelor's degree in natural resources. One job is forestry, and that involves planning for the harvesting of trees and then also planning for reforestation or replanting trees after a forest has been logged. If you enjoy a fire, you could also work in fire mitigation. And so this involves working on fire crews to help fight wildfires. It can also involve doing prescribed burns. And this is a fire prevention technique where you actually set controlled fires to kind of clear out a forest to burn off some of the things so that in the event of a wildfire, there's less fuel for that fire. Some other jobs related to natural resources are park management. And this is a very popular track for students in this area. If you've ever wanted to be a park ranger and hang out at Grand Canyon National Park, for example, and talk to people about the geology and ecology of the park, the Natural Resources Bachelor's Program is great preparation for that as well. The potential earnings in this field, most new graduates start off earning about $50,000 to $60,000 a year. Because the field is so specialized, you do need to have an associate degree in forestry in order to join this bachelor's program. So unlike our business programs and the IT programs, where you can have an associate degree in whatever area you want and then just complete some prerequisite courses as needed, here you really have to study forestry from the get-go. So the vast majority of students in our forestry program doing natural resources, bachelor's of applied science, they start off at Green River, they do their 2-year associate degree in forestry, and then transition on for their final 2 years in the bachelor's program. The prerequisites, as I mentioned, are that associate degree and also a 2.0 overall GPA. One of our newest bachelor's programs is our Bachelor in Early Childhood Education. So if you're someone who loves working with kids, this is a great program for you. The COVID-19 pandemic has really increased the need for childcare workers, as a lot of childcare centers have had to hire new workers in order to comply with new regulations around the number of childcare providers relative to the number of kids at any given center. So great opportunities in this field. You do have to have a specialized degree, associate degree, and early childhood education in order to begin this program. With that associate degree, you need to have a 2.5 GPA. And if you're transferring to Green River from another school and you've completed your associate and early ed there, we would check and make sure that you've completed all prerequisite coursework. If not, you might be looking at about 30 credits of prerequisite coursework before you can start the bachelor's program at Green River. The final program that I'll talk about is our aeronautical science bachelor's program. So this prepares you for all kinds of jobs in aviation. The most popular areas that our students go into after completing this degree are working as a pilot, working as an aircraft dispatcher, and also working in air traffic control. The admission to this field, the requirements are a 2.0 and an associate degree in aviation. So just like the early childhood ed, just like forestry, this is a very specialized field. So at the associate level, you do need to do an aviation-related associate degree. And most students will just start at Green River, do our aviation associates, and then progress directly into our bachelor's degree in aviation. A lot of the aviation classes are offered online, and this gives great flexibility to our pilot students who are busy taking classes, and they also need to get a lot of flight hours in order to get their different pilot ratings and licenses. And I know as an international student, there are requirements that you have a certain number of face-to-face classes every quarter. There are still plenty of gen ed classes that are face-to-face, so we can work with you to create a schedule that allows you to still meet all the requirements of your F1 visa while you're doing these online aviation classes. An exciting element of the Aeronautical Science Bachelor's Program is the fact that Green River College has been approved by the FAA for what's called a Restricted Airline Transport Pilot licensing. And the ATP license, this is kind of the finish line if you want to be a full officer for a commercial airline. And typically, in order to achieve that level, you have to have 1,500 hours of flight training. However, if you graduate from Green River with our bachelor's degree in aeronautical science, you only have to have 1,000 hours of flight training. So it really speeds up your progress towards that finish line. The way that students get flight hours oftentimes is they'll work as a flight instructor, and students get their certified flight instructor rating as part of this program. And as soon as they have that, we partner with 6 different flight schools in the area, and there's always high demand for flight instructors because as soon as a flight instructor gets those 1,000 hours, they're off and they're working for an airline. So there's constantly new openings. So you can work as a flight instructor, get paid, and simultaneously be building up those hours towards the 1,000 hours that you need for an airline transport pilot. And a lot of our aeronautical science students, they'll be building up their hours during OPT, which you might have heard of. OPT stands for Occupational Practical Training. And OPT is a job authorization that you can get after graduating with any degree. The nice thing about the bachelor's degree is that in certain degree areas, you can get the standard 12-month work authorization that comes with OPT. And you can also get what's called a STEM OPT extension, and that adds on 24 months to OPT. So the programs at Green River that are eligible for STEM OPT are the two IT programs, the software development and cybersecurity, the natural resources program, as well as the aviation program. So if you graduate from any of those degrees, you're eligible for 3 years of work authorization after you graduate. Automatically. You have to apply, but it's not a competitive program. Basically, if you have an employer, you can continue working there for 3 years after you graduate. And that's great because the standard OPT is 12 months, which is a good amount of time to get experience, but sometimes employers are reluctant to hire a student who they know will have to stop working after 12 months. And the reason for that is employers often invest quite a bit of time in training employees. So if the employee leaves after 12 months, the employer doesn't get to get that same return on that investment of training. But if you're there for 3 years, that employer is really getting a lot back from you. And so they're a lot more likely to hire you for kind of a standard full-time job in that case. So that is an overview of our bachelor's programs. I'm happy to answer any questions that anybody has. Taking a look at the comments here. If you have a comment, feel free to type it in there. Okay, not seeing any comments, so I'll sign off soon. If you'd like to learn more about these programs, please go to the Green River website, which is www.greenriver.edu. You can search for Bachelor's of Applied Science, which will take you to a page that shows all of these different programs. And the first step towards gaining admission in these programs is to fill out the request information form, which you'll see on the webpage for each individual program. Once you've done that, the program manager will contact you to set up a virtual one-on-one advising appointment where they'll talk a little bit about your educational background and help you to create a plan for getting into that program. So I hope you enjoyed this presentation. I hope you're interested in the Bachelor's in Applied Science programs. We'd be happy to welcome you to Green River. Thank you very much.